Welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on analyzing plan data using ad-hoc analysis in SmartView. You can start ad-hoc analysis mode from a cube or from a form. Starting from a cube gives you all dimensions at the top level. A form lets you start out focused on the members defined in the form layout. I'll start an ad-hoc analysis of the quarterly income statement form. I'll close the SmartView panel to show more of the screen. Initially, you see the rows and columns from the form. There is also a POV dialog box where you can select members for the POV. You can dock or hide the POV. The Planning Ad-Hoc ribbon provides quick access to ad-hoc analysis tasks. You can customize your ad-hoc grid by keeping or removing selected members. Let's say I want to review total revenue data for the second half of the year. I'll keep the total revenue member, and I'll remove the first two quarters. You can pivot dimensions to the POV, columns, or rows. The available choices depend on which axis the dimension is located before you pivot it. You can pivot a dimension from the POV to either the rows or columns by right-clicking and dragging it to the new location. I'll pivot the year dimension to the rows and the entity dimension to the columns. You can pivot a dimension that is currently in the rows or the columns by selecting a dimension member and clicking Pivot. When you select Pivot, if the dimension was in the column, your action moves it to the row. Similarly, if the dimension is in the row, your action moves it to the column. You cannot pivot the last dimension in a row or column. Because I'm analyzing only 1 year of data, I'll move the year back to the POV. You can select the members you want to view data for. For example, I'll select members for the entity dimension. You can remove any members that you don't want displayed. Next, I'll select members for the account dimension. You can search for a member. I'll refresh the data to see my changes. Selecting members from a POV dimension works a little differently. I'll select a product member. In the POV, I'll open the dimension dropdown and select the ellipsis to open the member selection dialog. I'll select members and remove any that I don't want displayed. Finally, I'll refresh to update the worksheet. You can zoom into a dimension hierarchy to display descendants that are not shown by default in the grid. I'll zoom in on total revenue. You can zoom in to the next level, all levels, or bottom level. After you create an ad-hoc grid, you can save it for future use. When you save the ad-hoc grid, you enter its name and an optional description. You can specify a folder in which to save your ad-hoc grid. In this tutorial, you saw how to connect to a planning application and perform ad-hoc analysis. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.